Hello friends, welcome to my lecture on lattices. We will define a lattice and we shall see some of its properties. A poset P is called a lattice if every two elements subset of P has both a least upper bound and a greatest lower bound. Least upper bound we denote by LUB. So, if x and y are any two elements of P, then LUB xy means least upper bound of xy, and GLB of xy means greatest lower bound of xy. So, P will be called a lattice if you take pick up any two elements of the set P, then you have the greatest lower bound as well as the least upper bound of the both the elements x and y of P. So, in this case this notation is called join of x and y. So, join of x and y is least upper bound of x y and meet of x and y. Okay. This notation means join of x and y, this notation means meet of x and y. So, meet of x and y is the greatest lower bound of x and y. Now, let us see an example of a lattice. The power set P s with inclusion relation is a lattice. Let A and B belong to P s, which is the power set of a set S. Okay. Then A union B is equal to join of A and B. Why? Because A join of A and B means least upper bound of A and B. Now, let us show that A union B is the least upper bound of A B. We can see it very easily. A is subset of A union B, B is subset of A union B. Okay. Hence, A union B is an upper bound of A and B. Now, let us show that it is the least upper bound of A and B. So, let us say C be any other upper bound of A and B. Let C be any upper bound of A and B. Then A is subset of C and B is subset of C, okay, which implies that A union B is a subset of C. Okay. So, we have seen that A union B is an upper bound of A and B, and if C is any upper bound of A and B, then A union B is contained in C. So, A union B is the least upper bound of A and B. Okay. Similarly, we can show that A intersection B is the greatest lower bound of A and B. So, A meet of A and B, which is greatest lower bound of A and B, let us show that it is A intersection B. Okay. So, we have to show that A intersection B is the greatest lower bound of A and B. We know that A intersection B is contained in A, and A intersection B is contained in B. Okay. So, A intersection B is a lower bound of A and B. Okay. Now, if C is any lower bound of A and B, if C is any lower bound of A and B, then C is subset of A, C is subset of B. Okay. So, this implies that C is subset of A intersection B. Okay. And therefore, A intersection B is the greatest lower bound of A and B. Okay. So, when A B belong to P S, then the greatest lower bound of A and B is A intersection B, and the least upper bound of A and B is the A union B, okay. And since it is PS, okay, so it contains all subsets of the set S. So, A union B and A intersection B also belong to PS, and therefore, if you take any two sets A and B in A and B in PS, then they are join and they are meet, they also belong to PS, and therefore, PS is a lattice. Now, let us show the poset Z plus, okay, Z set of positive integers. So, let us now show that Z plus with divisibility relation, okay, is a lattice, okay. So, let us take A and B belong to Z plus, okay. Then A join of A and B, it is LUB least upper bound of A and B, and A meet of A and B is equal to your least upper bound greatest lower bound, so GLB of A and B, okay. Let us show that least upper bound of AB, least upper bound of AB is equal to LCM of AB, okay. Least upper bound of AB is equal to LCM of AB, and greatest lower bound of AB is equal to GCD of AB. Okay. LCM means least common multiple of A and B, and GCD AB means greatest common divisor of A and B. Now, how it follows? You see, because of this divisibility relation, okay, least upper bound of AB means an upper bound, which first we should find an upper bound, okay, and that is an element which is divided by A and as well as B, okay. So, let us say let C be an element which is divided by A and B, okay. So, C must be a common multiple of A and B. Okay. So, this C, let us consider an upper bound, let us consider an upper bound of A and B. An upper bound of A and B means an element which is divided by both A and B. Now, that element then must be a common multiple of A and B, okay. So, least upper bound means least such element, okay, that is least common multiple of A and B. So, LUB of AB becomes least common multiple of A and B. Similarly, a lower bound of AB means an element, a lower bound of AB means an element which divides A as well as B, okay. So, if we find an element C which divides A and C also divides B, okay, then greatest lower bound, then it will be a lower bound of A and B, okay. If C divides A, C divides B, then C is a lower bound of A and B, okay. And we find greatest lower bound, this means that so C is a common divisor of A and B. We will find the greatest lower bound means greatest common divisor of A and B. So, greatest lower bound means GCD of A and B. For example, let us say suppose we take elements 4 and 6, okay. Let us take elements 4 and 6, then the join of 4 and 6. Join of 4 and 6 means LCM of 4 and 6. So, this is equal to 12, and if you take meet of 4 and 6, okay, meet of 4 and 6, then this is GCD of 4 and 6, and which is clearly equal to 2, okay. So, this is how we find the GCD and the least GCD of 4 and 6 and LCM of 4 and 6, and we see that both GCD of 4 and 6 and LCM of 4 and 6, they are again positive integers. So, when you take any two positive integers AB belonging to A and B belonging to Z plus, then they are meet and they are join. They are all again positive integers and therefore, they belong to Z plus. So, Z plus is a lattice. Now, determine whether the posets represented by each of the Hesse diagrams shown below are lattices. Let us see, this is a chain. Okay. So, A precedes B, B precedes C, C precedes D. Okay. And therefore, if we take A and B, if we take the pair A and B here, then A join B. Okay. A join B means A join B means least upper bound of A and B. Okay. A join B is least upper bound of A and B, that is an upper bound. Okay. That is an upper bound and which is the least. So, for A B, B is the least upper bound here. Okay. And then if you see A meet B, then it is GLB of A B. Okay. So, GLB is clearly A here. Okay. So, if you take A B, then A join B equal to B, A meet B equal to A, which are again elements belonging to A B C D set. Okay. So, if you take A C or you see B C or you take C D, you again can find that the meet of the two or the join of the two are again A, B, C, R, D. So, they belong to the given set and therefore, it is a lattice. Now, let us go to this figure. Let us look at this Hesse diagram. Here, what do we notice? That E and G, okay? E and G do not have, if you take E and G, then E meet G, okay, is least upper bound of E and G. Okay. So, E and G do not have least upper bound, they do not have any upper bound. Okay. So, they do not have any least upper bound and therefore, this is not a lattice. Let us go to this figure. Okay. Here, we see that BC, if you consider BC, okay, then the BC has three upper bounds D, E and F. The upper bounds for B and C are D, E, F. Now, there is no one of them precedes the other two. Since no one of them precedes the other two, okay, we do not have least upper bound of BC. So, least upper bound of BC, which is a join of B and C, this does not exist. Okay. And so, this is again not a lattice. Okay. Now, let us go to properties of lattices. So, let us say let L be a lattice, okay, let L be a lattice, then for every A and B in L, let us show that join of AB equal to B if and only if A precedes B. Okay. So, first let us consider let join of A B be equal to B. Okay. Let us say we are given that join of A and B is equal to B and we have to show that A precedes B. Okay. Now, let us recall the definition of join of A and B. A join of A and B equal to least upper bound of A B. Okay. So, what we can say by the definition, it follows that since join of A and B is least upper bound of A and B, it follows that A precedes join of AB. Okay, it is the it is the least upper bound. So it is an upper bound. Upper bound means A precedes A join of A and B. But join of A and B is given to be equal to B. So we have A precedes B. Okay. Now let us prove the converse. Okay. Conversely, let A precedes B. Okay. We have to show that join of AAB is equal to B. Okay. Okay. Now we notice that B precedes B. Okay. B precedes B. So we are given that A precedes B and B precedes B. Therefore, B is an upper bound of A and B. B is an upper bound of A and B. Now, this is least upper bound of A and B. Therefore, join of A and B must precede B. Okay, join of A and B must precede B. Again, join of A and B is an upper bound of A and B. So, B precedes join of A and B. Okay. Now, what do we have? B precedes join of A and B, and A and B precedes B. Therefore, by antisymmetry. Okay. So, since B precedes join of A and B, and A and B precedes B, okay, by antisymmetry, join of A and B is equal to B. Okay, so this is the proof of the part A. Part B can be similarly shown. Okay, and once you have the parts A and B, part C follows by by transitivity, because we have to show that meet of A and B equal to A if and only if join of A and B equal to B. Okay. Now meet of, now let us use the part B. Okay. So A meet of E and B equal to A if and only if A precedes B. Okay. Now A, now let us use part A. A precedes B if and only if join of A and B equal to B. Okay. So meet of A and B equal to A if and only if join of A and B equal to B. So the third follows, C part follows by using the transitivity and the parts A and B. So, with that, I would like to end my lecture. Thank you very much for your attention.